The National Science Week that kicked off on Monday, 6th November 2023, has entered a fourth day at Kololo Ceremonial Grounds. Several scientists and innovators are showcasing different innovations and ideas that they have initiated over time. The innovators want the government to support them so that they play their part in the transformation of the country. Upon his arrival to the National Science Week at Kololo Ceremonial Grounds, President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni started with a mini tour of the exhibition stalls. In her speech, the Minister of Science, Technology and Innovation, Dr. Monica Musenero, commended the President for the continuous support towards the country's innovation sector. She, however, pointed out some challenges facing the science sector that she wants to be addressed. In a passionate appeal, Musenero asked the president to allocate annual funds of 500 billion shillings to her ministry.
All the support you have given us, but we need to continue to seek your guidance on funding for STI. The funding is still limited. For example, for 2 years now, Hiramotos gets money only for salaries, and we are unable to move. And we have so many things. We found a resolution one time by cabinet that we should allocate at least 500 billion to STI annually for a certain period that will be able to nurture a number of innovations that will give the economy a takeoff.
The way I have seen things here and the way they have been moving in, we need to have a special vote for science and technology, where we will deposit money and nobody can cut it down or put in more without your consultation and even the Minister of Finance.
She also reported to the President a section of Ugandans who have continued to frustrate her efforts by giving false information about the country's innovations.
We are trying to brand this nation as a great nation, an innovative nation, a place where investors should come. However, there are a lot of people who flippantly talk about the nation. And when many of these investors are searching, what first pops up are scandals. And many of the scandals are imaginary. Your Excellency, you gave us freedom of speech, but I think we need to draw a line somewhere and manage such that the positive stories go off so we can attract investment into the country.
On his part, President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni reiterated government's commitment to fund the science, technology and innovation sector of the country. He agreed to give the science sector a seed capital of 500 billion shillings annually.
If we want to do something, we emphasize it ahead of all other things. Recently, we were able to put more than 1 trillion into the PDM program. 1 trillion shillings. Year after year, year after year. So even here, this 500 billion you are talking about, this is not a lot of money. We can put it.
The president was bitter with government officials taxing the innovations. He says that they deserve to be imprisoned for their actions.
Something already well known, but you are putting it here in Uganda for the first time, we give you tax holiday for 10 years. How can anybody tax a baby when he has not been taxing adults who have just arrived on the scene?
On a lighter note, the president was happy with the religious leaders who have started changing their mindset towards science, arguing that aligning religion with science is the way to go.
Linking God's work with science and emphasizing science, because science, this wind, this is science. Who created the wind? Am I the one who created the wind? Or is this the scientist? It is nature. And nature is God. If you believe in God, you must believe in science.
After the speeches, 7 eminent persons who have greatly contributed towards the growth of science and technology in the country were awarded. This year's National Science Week attracted a number of investors. The investors committed to support the innovations in the country. The annual Science Week that will end on Saturday, 11th November 2023, is running under the theme Uganda to Simbudde, our science-led journey towards socio-economic transformation. Report compiled by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.